This game is called the Flappy Bird game. Let's click on the flag to start it. Now I'll click on the start button to start it. I have to click on the mouse to make the bird fly. And if this bird goes from between the pillars, then 1-1 points will be increased. This is a tough game. So like once every single time the size of the pillars can increase, the size of the pillars can decrease. So I went from one pillar, so the point became one. I went from two pillars, so the point became two. Hope you like.
Hannah is a radio jockey who is famous for her prank calls. She connects to her listeners by pranking them and asking them funny questions. Hello my love listeners out there. This is Archie Hannah only on 93.5 Sky FM with your favorite program Disturbing. I got a call from Dream. Today he set to do a prank call to his friend Athar. He told me that Athar is a serious personality and hates to answer too many questions. He finds his happiness by winning gift hampers. So I have decided to call Athar and do what I do the best. Disturbing. Hello, am I talking to Mr. Athar?
Yes, who's this?
This is Lisa calling from Holiday Abroad.
Okay, but I am a bit busy now. Can't speak.
But sir, you have won a gift hamper.
What? But how?
I mean to say, you have a chance to win a package trip to Hong Kong for 4 days, 5 nights. All expenses starting from the tickets to stay and the food will be upon us. All you will have to do is give at least one correct answer out of 4 questions.
Well, okay, this should be easy. Shoot!
First question. How do you put an elephant in a fridge?
What? I don't know.
Easy, you just open the fridge and put it in.
That's a ridiculous question. I don't want to play this game. Please don't waste my time.
But sir, you get to win a free holiday package. Remember?
Alright, next question.
No. you just open the fridge, take out the elephant, and then put the donkey inside. Okay. Let me ask another one. If all the animals went to the lion's birthday party and one animal went missing, which one it would be?
I don't know.
It's the donkey, because it's still inside the fridge.
Are you kidding me?
No. So, okay, one last question. The chance of winning is still there.
Okay.
If there's a river full of crocodiles and you wanted to cross, how would you?
There is no way I would need a boat to cross.
No. So, you just swim and cross the river. Because all the animals, including crocodiles, went to the lion's birthday party.
Enough!
But you want to hear something even more strange? My computer has been speaking to me. No, I'm serious. It's that computer right there. It happened at random times, like at night when I'm in bed and looking at my phone. At first, it was just saying things like turn off your music or turn off your light. But then it started to get even more complex. It started asking me to do favors for it. Like it told me to buy this new computer game and have a chip to the house. Of course I didn't do it, because it is a computer. What it is going to do to me? Well, the next day, my room was a complete mess and something smelled like it died in here. And on the screen, it said, "You should have done what I asked." That was the last time I messed with my supernatural computer. When the next day the computer asked me to order it food, I didn't question it and ordered that food right away. I ordered it from my house, but it never arrived. The doorbell never rang, and my app told me that it arrived. I don't know where it went. Maybe the app and the computer are working together? Wait! Did you hear that? You heard that, right? See, I am not crazy. It just asked you to write a 3-page paper about the independence movement. Wait a minute. My little brother is supposed to write an essay about the independence movement. Oh, he's so dead! Excuse me. Jaydev, where are you? Jaydev!
The white clock on the wall is mocking me, counting down the minutes until I fail this test. It makes no sense. Hey, why aren't there any posters hung up in Miss Daniel's room? I never noticed that before. I need something to take my mind off this paper. This paper that will destroy my average. Oh my god, I'm grinding my teeth. I never grind my teeth. Wow, look how interesting this pencil looks when I twirl it. Why is the second hand on my clock moving so slowly? And how is everyone else still working on this test? I can't make any sense of it. I read the novel. I actually read the novel. But this question doesn't make any sense. Look at Hannah, furiously scribbling. I hate her. She knows the answers to everything. Miss Daniels is reading a book? Really? At a time like this, she's just sitting there reading. There's the bell. But my paper is still blank. I think I'm going to have a heart attack. Great. Everyone's getting ready to go.
I had better done it on my paper. But really, what's the point? It's blank. I guess I'll just turn it in. Wait, what? Miss Daniels is going to grade our papers right now. How can she do that? I think I'm going to turn to stone. She's making everyone sit back down. Why is she shuffling through the papers so fast? Wait, she stopped on one. I think it's mine. Here we go. My heart's pounding through my chest. She's going to announce to everyone that I've failed. Wait, what? I'm the only one who passed? It was a test to see if we could read directions. And it said not to write anything down? Ha! Take that, Hannah. Take that, clock.
Five people walked into a house. Joe, Bob, Fred, Mike, and Jane. Everyone is sleeping over at Mike's house, because they are going to see a concert the next day. Jane is a very big spender. Mike likes to read and hates Bob. Bob is very loud. He hates Mike. Joe is very good with money. He bought the tickets to the concert. Fred is very tough and has been to prison. The next morning, everyone wakes up and finds that Mike is dead. They all have excuses. Fred claims to have been napping. Joe says he was buying the tickets and waves the four tickets in the air. Jane claims she was at the mall. The next day, three people arrive at the concert. Mike is dead and someone else is in prison. Who killed Mike? Joe killed Mike. But how do we know? He only bought four tickets, three for his friends and one for himself, because he knew that Mike would be dead and would not be in need of a ticket. So that's all, folks, from Detective Avnika Malara. Now, if you see a crime, you know whom to call.